voice. Hopefully you can hear the voice. Alright, then why don't we just play Cherry Shuffle.
Jojo, move.
Oh.
Jojo.
I found it on the Scottish Fiddler site. So I'm wondering, well anyway, I just really wanted to be in the loop.
Great, okay, well, you know, maybe,
I think
we have your email, right?
Yeah, Sherry put up there.
Okay, right, okay, yeah. we'll get you on our list.
Awesome.
Yeah.
That's perfect. Oh, this is excellent. So what brought you to Alameda?
It's kids. Community, El Cerrito. So not far. And then, you know, it's a little closer to where I work. And so, so it's
beautiful.
Go for it, man.
You have some adorable kids. I think they're yours. Yeah.
They just some of them are mine.
Are the ones that were playing the mandolin and the fiddle?
Yes. Those are ours. Okay.
Well, wonderful to meet you.
Great.
Your
you too.
Your name is
Chris.
I'm Sherry. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I'm glad you can make it.
Your name is on what line?
No.
Because they see the
Just through this room right here, and there's a door to your left, so please help yourself there. If you'd like to go and spend some time in the backyard, please do, but if you have little ones especially, we'd really like you to be careful of the pool. And we do kind of, are kind of hoping that for folks with young kids, that we kind of would hope that, you know, we'll have as many eyes as we can, but we do like for you to keep an eye on your own young ones. And then we'll see how the spacing works out, but if there might be room for a couple kids up here, if need be. My name is Chris Quayle. My family has been very fortunate to be in touch with the Claridges over the last several years. The boys have gone to Tristan Tashina's Mount Shasta camp, and they also have done Big Sur for the last couple of years. And I didn't get to go this year, which really kind of makes me sad. But from what I understand, everyone had a really fantastic week of music, and so I thank you all are going to get to see the fruits of a lot of what went on during the camp. And the camps are really these really amazing kind of weeks of creativity and music and fun and community. And so I think you'll probably hear a lot of that come out in the playing. So I'm going to kind of just turn it over to Tristan and Tashina. They are the staff at the Big Sur Fiddle Camp and kind of the driving force. So I don't know if Tashina is.
Can we move this somewhere?
She's coming.
Yeah, she's coming. Okay.
She's on Big Sur time.
She's on Big Sur. Yeah. So if you guys don't know about Big Sur time or Shasta time,
thank you for.
Yeah. Just take a clock and set it back to some number. But like I said, it's always, no matter what, it's always worth the wait. And so I'm going to hand it over to Tristan Tashina. So please welcome Tristan Tashina Claridge.
Thank you.
Collaborations coming up here. And most of us have, of course, just been hanging out at this music camp down in Big Sur and playing tunes together all last week. And this is kind of the close of all of that. And
this culmination,
yeah. Of what we've, the common ground we've all found together musically. And although actually the folks coming up have a lot of musical common ground already, and they play together quite often. So you'll be seeing some collaborations who've played a lot together and some who've played much less together and just kind of really exploring. So hope we all enjoy the journey together. And we're going to start by bringing up John Reichman, Scott Nygaard, and Sharon Gilchrist.
Sharon play together, and we're working on a recording, and we'll play a couple tunes from that for you.
In case you're wondering, there's a lot more music that goes on at these camps than sleep, so for a little bit, it seems like it's 3 in the morning all the time.
Thank you.
he can still only afford one strap.
One pick.
It's a sad story.
Probably spent all the money on each meeting.
Since we were at a fiddle camp, we thought we'd play fiddle tunes, which we just did. That was the Road to Malvern, a recently composed old tune. This is also a somewhat recently composed old waltz composed by Ben Thomason's father.
Ron?
Ron?
Is that Ben Thomason's father?
Luke.
Thank you.
All right, coming up next, a wonderful, wonderful old-time musician. We're lucky to have him out on the West Coast for a little bit. And also a wonderful fiddle player coming up to play fiddle with him. Welcome, John Herman and Emily Mann.
This song. I need to be on this side of her because my hearing is really bad. And this one works. I play with these two other people at home. They're both about 70. And one day Hillary said, "You know that band, The Who?"
"Yeah."
"We're the what?" "What?" So I like to have the fiddle pointing at me. So, I made up this non-sectarian, non-religious sort of gospel song, and the roots of it were that I heard a Laurie Lewis song on the radio, and I misheard it. So there was a line in there. I thought that would make a good song. And so, let's see, I need it. I wandered through this life of stranger, filled with sorrow, filled with strife. I had no hope of earth or heaven, a weary traveler tired of life. And when I'd reached my darkest hour, I turned my face unto the wall. I vowed I would no longer cower. Then I let my burden fall. Now I've found a true salvation. I have no fear of pain or grave. I bowed my head to all creation and found that all the world is saved. I know that every man's my brother. I see my kin on every hand. I know my father and my mother. I lay me down with the wolf and the lamb. I know that every man's my brother, nor do I seek more precious pearl. We travel through this life together. There are no strangers in this world. Subliminal for the redundant. This is Bucking Mule.
try something out. We're going to keep John up here and play a Texas-style fiddle breakdown.
What key are we going to be playing?
G.
Good.
And we're going to have Lucas come up and join us on bass.
With only four of us, and later on we'll kind of get a big crowd. None of you guys, you're welcome to come up and join us. I was thinking of playing just like maybe just like a tune, like Mother's Riches or something.
Yeah.
welcome Kristen Andreessen. And don't mind the traffic jam in the hallway, it's going to be common. And we love Yatka to sing some harmony on this one.
Yeah. Is your fiddle still in that great tuning? This came about because we were sitting in the room and Tashina said, my fiddle's in this A tuning. And then we thought of this old time song. So this is an old one that I learned from recording of Uncle Dave Macon playing it. And then later found out it was sort of like a Broadway hit or something in the teens. Sometimes composed, music for the intelligentsia would make its way into the old time repertoire. This apparently is one of them. So there's other recordings of these kind of like beautiful like tenors with vibrato. Wait till the clouds roll by, Jenny. And that's about half the chorus right there. Wait till the clouds roll by, Jenny.
Absolutely no idea.
idea what it is.
Quick, where's your cheat sheet?
I know, a cheat sheet. I usually write on my hand, but I was trying to, like, look nice tonight. Can I get a little help assistance from the back about what the next thing is? That's why you didn't show
it.
They're learning it. No, no worries. Oh my goodness. No, wait.
Did you hear him? I heard the rumor of what the set list had been changed to. Did you catch that? We were talking back there. We're going to get John Herman back up. Along with Grace and Nandi Forrest.
Thank you. Well, yeah, actually.
This is pretty unique to get like consensus.
What was it that was consensus
in one year? It's like each, like most of these people, most of all of them, each man.
The acoustics in here are great.
So people are like musicians.
Yeah, yeah. It's
I mean,
it is.
I think the curves are
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah. It all just works.
Yeah. He's up until like 1 o'clock every night.
You're just tired.
Yeah. And he's claiming this is his favorite. He's claiming this.
No, it's him.
No, no. Yeah, no, it's him.
Oh, no.
Yes. There might be distracting. But I opened the one over there. I opened the one over there.
Holy, I
think it will be probably.
Like,
I
can't
do it.
I was holding.
Oh, were you?
I love it.
You can just go like this.
Yeah, let me finish this. We're at
intermission.
I'm going to battle.
Okay. Yeah, some of the girls that are here, she and they and their family went to Sky.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, they said it was like a once-in-a-lifetime experience.
Sky is...
Is all
Sky
of yeah, all of the camp is
Sky. Oh,
yeah.
There's one in Spain, too.
Yeah. So they went to... Yeah.
An Alistair camp, yeah.
Yeah, so right. Like there's one more. Yeah, so they went to the Woodland Sky, and they said it was amazing.
Are you
so, I don't know. I mean, that would be... See,
that would be like...
Because, like, you know, the one thing is, like, you know, kind of, like, as... You know, I have a limited amount of time I can take off. And so we somehow we have Weezer for a week, and that's why we can't go to Sierra's with that. Because they started doing this like national contest. And then they have Big Sur, which I can't go to, but then they have Big Sur and Shasta camp. It's in July. It's like we're soon after Weezer. It's like Weezer 1 week back and then Shasta. And then they have like you know Walker Creek they want to go to. So like and then they have like those like days
so off. Much for like Christmas.
Yeah.
Holiday.
Exactly. So you know like I mean which is great because it's been really really fun.
Yeah.
But then that also means like we haven't gone on like a non-music like really fun vacation for a while.
Yeah.
We didn't go to the Star Wars convention last year, which was and Anaheim was awesome.
That's awesome.
Yeah, like 3 days of Star Wars nerdery and then one day is but we haven't had very much of that since so like one of the painful things about the job is I've been in another company for a while. So I think I was up to like almost 5 years of vacation, right? Which was really hard. So like 2 weeks or just like 2 weeks. That's like, yeah. But I'm like, you know, like you're supposed to give out, you know, like 2 weeks, two extra weeks with the kids.
Yeah.
And then I mean, maybe for that long, but he was very, very slow. And yeah, it's like of all the things, you know, like, yeah, like you have to wait like 3 years until you can get like any.
Oh my gosh!
Yeah, it's a little bit. Yeah, so, that's a great place. It's an amazing company. I'm a statistician.
It's been
really, Here, but it's probably gonna do maybe better.
Well, I was just
yeah. And I'm assuming we're going to get started pretty soon. Maybe we should bank on it.
Thank you. I think Becky's going to have to
So this is a love song. Trust me. You guys good?
We are.
One, two.
Like everybody, I love something.
come now. You're allowed. Welcome one of my favorite fiddle players, Luke Price. Simon Christman on the bass.
You guys already played a game today, right? Is that right? How'd it go?
It was a blast.
Very nice.
So what are we playing, Scott?
Sandu. Key of E-flat.
Thank you.
Welcome Leela, Rainey, and Ray playing along with Simon. Rainey and the Rattlesnakes.
Thank you. welcome Kristen and Andreas back to the stage.
Yeah.
Basically after the subject of this song happened. They had a pastor who decided one day, he came into church and he said, "You guys, I reread the whole Bible and I did all the calculations over again and I know exactly when the end of the world is and it's way sooner than any of us thought. It's like next month." And this is a completely 100% true story that I heard from my grandfather after, well, you'll hear the story and how it happens in the song, but they all went up to the highest point outside of Eugene, and they sang songs all night, and they waited for the second coming, and then I think what ended up happening is my grandfather decided to learn English and join the other Lutheran church. The next day.
Here up the Mackenzie River, clear the timber.
appear to be the only one in common between this last tune and this next one. I'm hoping that the other people who are about to play on this roll, yeah, why not, John?
Why not?
Hearty welcome.
Why not?
Yeah. Anyone with the initials John Wright back there, or the initials Sharon Gilchrist?
Am I involved in this?
You're involved.
Okay.
This is another all-time tune that's sort of an ode to staying up late. called 4:30. Thank you.
folks often know Simon as a bass player these days, but this is his instrument he's definitely played the longest. Though he's certainly excellent at bass.
This is the instrument that I've been the most frustrated with. Inspired by hanging out in Big Sur, going for a walk in the evening and being told, well, you probably shouldn't do that because you might get eaten by something. And then I was trying to think of like band names because I love thinking of basically dumb band names that you would never want to actually name a band. And I thought of the Ouch, I'm Being Eaten by a Leopard String Quartet. And then that became this kid's story about this guy Theodore who gets eaten by a leopard.
Quartet?
No, it's just one guy. And then this song came from that, so it's kind of that's the history of it. Which I'm telling you because I'm out of tune.
That's fine.
I tried to do some tuning back there, but the dulcimer really appreciates being in whatever context of temperature it's going to be in, so there wasn't really any point because it was just going to change when we came out here.
Exactly.
It's worth it, I
sure. By which we mean it's better to hear an in-tune dulcimer than a really out-of-tune
to me.
Thank you.
John for being so willing to explore with us, having never played that tune before in his life.
That
was
really fun.
Really, really nice
fun.
To hear. Thank you, Ben.
Scary.
So we've got Nutty Forest to come up and sing a song for you guys now. And I want to say, for those of you who are young or have to go to work really early in the morning, that we know it's school night and we don't mind if you have to head home. We'll miss you, but not that much. Just kidding. Just saying, we understand. We're going to do two more. We're going to do a bluegrass tune. Nani's going to play a bluegrass tune, and then we're going to have a Texas-style jam to cap off the evening. We'll turn it over to Nani now.
This is one of my favorite bluegrass songs, and I learned it from a Tony Rice recording. It's called "I'll Just Stay Around."
It's like a brother duet.
Yeah, right. Yeah. I met some new musicians at the fiddle camp in. I'd never met Nutty before, but that was kind of a highlight for me, is getting to play music with him and hearing him, listening to him. Anybody else coming up?
I think this is us. I'll probably be a variety of things.
Thank you.
You're two.
Sure. Sometime, and here it is. Thanks for being part of it.